Greetings, loved ones. Let's take a journey. I know a place where the grass is really greener. Warm, wet and wild. There must be something in the water. Sipping gin and juice. Laying underneath the palm trees. Yeah. And
Good morning, MHS.
I'm Nick Orchanian.
And I'm Millie Bohn.
And this is MHS Info. I bet you guys missed us. Millie, take it with the news.
Congrats to boys varsity lacrosse who defeated Niska Yuna in the regional semifinal on Wednesday with a final score of 11-6. Niska Yuna, who beat the Tigers last year in the regional semifinal, was ranked number 2 in the Class A state poll with the state's longest winning streak at 19 games. That distinction now belongs to the Tigers at 19 games. Declan Harrigan, Will Martin, and Henry Rayner all scored, as well as Tom Conley, the top scorer, with 5 goals. The Tigers play again on Saturday at 10 a.m. Good luck to them.
As summer approaches, there will be lots of exciting events happening outdoors. For now, here's a quick promo about an event next week you don't want to miss.
In pop culture news, while the Khloe Kardashian, Tristan Thompson, and Jordan Woods scandal may have died down, Sophie Schauer sat down recently with Jordan to get her side of the story, as well as talk about some other questionable activities right here at MHS. The interview was produced by Sophie and myself. Let's take a look.
So, Jordan, thanks for sitting down with us today. Rumor has it you got caught for parking in staff the other morning when you were late to first period. What's your side of the story?
That is not the truth, but if you're looking for a story, I can understand why that would be the story.
There are pictures of your brand new Mercedes that Kylie Jenner just bought you parked diagonally across two spots that are clearly reserved for the principal and the athletic director.
Now, this seems completely crazy.
You can clearly tell you're not supposed to park there. What was going through your head?
I'm not thinking I shouldn't be here.
So when you were sent to Ms. Klein's office, what went down?
So this is where the story gets tricky. I allowed myself to be in that position.
And then why wouldn't you just park on J Row?
Not because of malicious intent, but because I was just scared.
All right. Changing the subject, Angie told me she saw you eating in the library the other day. Is that true?
Never a consideration, never happened, and never will I. Attach me to a lie detector, whatever it is.
You're willing to take a lie detector test to prove that you didn't eat in the library?
I couldn't eat. I didn't eat for days. I couldn't look at my phone even.
Okay, Jordan. Thanks for your time. This interview has been, confusing.
With only 12 days left of classes in the school year, you may be wondering, just what did you learn this year? Will I ever need to know this stuff again? Or maybe it's more than just for our regions. For our last featured news story of the day, Matt Segal, Millie Bohn, and I talked with some teachers and students about what we are learning and what we really want to learn in high school. Roll it!
What's up, MHS? Recently, many people have questioned if high school adequately prepares students for the real world. So we set out to determine if this idea applies right here at MHS. Let's check it out.
High school is, it's not only to learn the content, but it is also to get you ready for college and for what's coming after.
You know, you go through these sections of failure where things don't work exactly the way that you want them to work, but then you kind of push on and try different things.
We're trying to instill good values and good morals to make you good citizens.
Nobody expects to learn everything about the world in 4 short years, but some students wish that they were taught specific skills.
It would be cool if high schools taught you how to drive. They just don't even talk about it here.
I wish high school had taught me how to like deal with money in the real world, credit cards, stuff like that.
Some students believe that some things they learn in school will not help them later in life.
The things that you learn in class in high school probably don't teach you that much. Like the lessons you learn outside of the classroom, dealing with stress and dealing with work, that's something that will prepare you for the rest of your life.
Although not everything we learn applies to the real world, the habits and work ethic we develop do.
You need that experience to mature, but I wouldn't say it's like the main requisite into going into the real world. Like you need other experiences.
Just keep on trying different things. So like explore and push your own boundaries.
Being independent is really important, but it's okay to seek out help and rely on other people if you need things.
In the end, high school is here to help you mature and develop as a learner and as a person. Ultimately, teachers only want the best for their students and do all they can to make sure they succeed once we walk out these doors.
We really do have to take care of ourselves, not only physically, but mentally as well. There are people to reach out to if you feel like things are getting rough and that there are people to talk to and that, you know, we're not just teachers, we're allies. We're here to, you know, be there for you if you should ever need us.
We only have 3 more info shows left.
And 12 more days of class.
And then summer is here, and I'll be doing nothing.
And that was MHS Info.